हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल जियोग्राफी क्लास फॉर आईसीएसई एंड माध्यमिक। टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट द जियोग्राफी क्लास ऑफ आईसीएसई फॉर क्लास 8 एंड स्पेशली दिस क्लास इज डेडिकेटेड टू माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स दोज हु आर स्टेइंग एट देयर होम ड्यूरिंग दिस सिचुएशंस एंड होप यू गाइज यू आर स्टेइंग एट योर होम एंड यू आर कंटिन्यूइंग योर लर्निंग। सो टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट द जियोग्राफी क्लास फॉर आईसीएसई Class 8. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the definition of the topographical map, and one definition is coming on your screen. You can see, you can read it. That is, topographical maps are maps of a small area that show many details. Those maps are drawn on large scales with physical and cultural features by using different symbols and colors. It means the map from where we are getting the physical and cultural features both. And all the features will be given by symbol and different type of color. So here one thing you have to remember, that is symbols and colors are very important to read the topographical map. And another point you have to remember, that the topographical map always will be made by the help of the representative fractions. Okay, so topographical map ek aisa map hai jahan par hum log फिजिकल फीचर्स और कल्चरल फीचर्स एक ही मैप से हम लोग देख सकते हैं। फिजिकल और कल्चरल फीचर्स को कैसे रिप्रेजेंट किया जाता है? कुछ सिंबल्स के द्वारा और कुछ कलर्स के द्वारा ये रिप्रेजेंट किया जाता है। सो जो मैप बहुत ही मिनिमम एरिया को रिप्रेजेंट करता है और जहाँ पर डिफरेंट टाइप का सिम्बॉल्स यूज होते हैं, जहाँ पर डिफरेंट टाइप का कलर्स यूज होते हैं और स्पेशली रिप्रेजेंटेटिव फ्रैक्शंस जो एक अलग टाइप का स्केल है, इसी स्केल को यूज करते हुए टोपोग्राफिकल मैप को बनाया जाता है। सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया इज वन ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशंस दोज हु आर मेकिंग द टोपोग्राफिकल मैप आफ्टर द सर्वे। सो कम टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज द फीचर्स ऑफ द टोपोग्राफिकल मैप। एंड हियर यू कैन सी द टू फीचर्स आर गिवन। वन इज रिप्रेजेंटेटिव फ्रैक्शंस इज यूज्ड टू मेक द टोपोग्राफिकल मैप, आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेड। एंड physical and cultural elements can be shown in the same map. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि एक ही मैप से हम लोग फिजिकल फीचर्स को भी देख सकते हैं और कल्चरल एलिमेंट्स को भी हम लोग यहाँ से देख सकते हैं। और किस तरह का एलिमेंट्स यहाँ पर मिलेगा, लाइक रिलीफ फीचर्स, नेचुरल वेजिटेशन, सेटलमेंट, रोड, इट मीन ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड सो मेनी थिंग्स, सोशल एक्टिविटीज, you can understand from the topographical map. So now we are going to see the topographical map on our screen. यहाँ पर हम देखेंगे कि topographical map में features कैसे होते हैं। तो एक map आप लोग screen में देख सकते हैं। यहाँ पर मैं आप लोगों को कुछ features को identify करते हुए आप लोगों को समझाऊंगा कि कैसे टोपोग्राफिकल मैप से रीड किया जाता है। यहाँ पर देखिए आप लोग, ये जो फीचर्स दिखाई दे रहा है इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं सेटलमेंट। यहाँ पर जो ब्लू कलर में दिखाया जा रहा है इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं वाटर बॉडीज। यहाँ पर जो फीचर्स दिखाई दे रहा है, ये जो फीचर्स आ रहा है इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं रिवर, इसको बोलते हैं रिवर। तो रिवर हो गया एक फिजिकल फीचर्स, ये हो गया एक कल्चरल फीचर्स। और यहाँ पर जो रेड लाइन दिखाई दे रहा है इस तरह से, इसको बोलते हैं कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। सो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इट इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट, इट इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ रोडवेज, यू कैन ऑल्सो से दैट। सो यहाँ पर जो ग्रीन कलर का फीचर्स दिखाई दे रहा है, यहाँ पर पूरा एरिया, जो एरिया मैं मार्क कर रहा हूँ आप लोग देख सकते हैं, इस एरिया में पूरा ग्रीन कलर से कवर किया हुआ है। इसका मतलब क्या हुआ, ग्रीन कलर से टोपोसीट में नेचुरल वेजिटेशन को रिप्रेजेंट किया जाता है। सो ये एरिया में टोटल नेचुरल वेजिटेशन है और इधर भी थोड़ा सा दिखाई दे रहा है। आप देखेंगे यहाँ पर कुछ वर्टिकल्स और हॉरिजॉन्टल्स रेड लाइन हम लोगों को दिखाई दे रहा है। इधर से ये सब वर्टिकल्स लाइन्स हैं, यहाँ पर हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन्स कुछ दिखाई दे रहे हैं। तो पहले मैं बता देता हूं कि ये सारे जो लाइंस दिखाई दे रहा है उसके साथ साथ एक नंबर्स भी दिया हुआ है. सो इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं स्ट्रिंग्स, इसको बोलते हैं स्ट्रिंग्स. और जो हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइंस होते हैं, ये सब हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइंस हैं, यहाँ पर भी कुछ नंबर्स दिखाई दे रहा है, इसको बोलते हैं नॉर्डिंग्स. सो स्ट्रिंग्स और नॉर्डिंग्स क्या हेल्प करता है, स्ट्रिंग्स और नॉर्डिंग्स हेल्प करता है कोई भी एक फीचर्स का लोकेशन आइडेंटिफिकेशन के लिए. यहाँ पर एक ब्लैक डॉट दिखाई दे रहा है, उसके साथ साथ एक नंबर्स दिखाई दे रहा है. क्या नंबर्स है ये? 422. 422 का मतलब क्या हुआ? इसका मतलब होता है स्पॉट हाइट. स्पॉट हाइट इट इज फीचर्स ऑफ द टोपोग्राफिकल मैप एंड थ्रू दिस फीचर्स यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द हाइट ऑफ द प्लेस फ्रॉम द मीन सी लेवल. यहाँ पर और एक फीचर्स दिखाई दे रहा है, इसको बोलते हैं फायर लाइन, जो ब्लैक डॉट से दिखाया जा रहा है. ब्लैक डॉटेड लाइन यहाँ पर दिखाई दे रहा है, जिसको बोलते हैं फायर लाइन. फायर लाइन का मतलब क्या होता है? टू प्रोटेक्ट द फायर, टू प्रोटेक्ट द फॉरेस्ट फायर एक्चुअली. तो यहाँ पर कल्चरल फीचर्स कौन सा है और फिजिकल फीचर्स कौन सा है? फिजिकल फीचर्स यहाँ पर दिखाई दे रहा है रिवर है, और भी फिजिकल फीचर्स होते हैं लाइक कॉनिकल हिल, रिज, माउंटेन, प्लेटोज, प्लेन्स, ये सारे जो फीचर्स हम लोग टोपोसिट से देखते हैं. तो ये सारे फीचर्स हो जाते हैं फिजिकल फीचर्स. और कल्चरल फीचर्स में क्या आते हैं? जैसे सेटलमेंट, और आते हैं एग्रीकल्चरल एक्टिविटीज, और आते हैं सोशल एक्टिविटीज, ये सारे चीज़ हो जाएंगे कल्चरल फीचर्स. पॉपुलेशन और जो मैनमेड होते हैं ये सारे कल्चरल फीचर्स ही होते हैं, और जो नेचुरल होते हैं वो सारे फिजिकल फीचर्स होते हैं. सो ये हो जाता है एक 3D फॉर्म सरफेस का, एक 3D फॉर्म है. सो यहाँ पर जो आप लोगों को दिखाई दे रहा है ये सारे हो जाते हैं कंटूर का शेप, कंटूर लेयरिंग भी बोल सकते हैं हम लोग. सो ये हो जाते हैं टोपोग्राफिकल मैप का एक इंट्रोडक्शन. सो अब आते हैं नेक्स्ट टॉपिक पर. Now students, I will tell you how to represent the relief in toposit. So first of all, I would like to say you what is the meaning of the relief. Relief means the average height of any place from the mean sea level. It means it is the elevation of the surface, that is called relief. Easily we can say that it is the altitude from mean sea level, that is called relief. So there are so many processes to represent the altitude of any place from the mean sea level. So in toposit, first of all we will see that is the first process to represent the relief of any places from the mean sea level in toposit, that is contours. So first of all we are going to discuss the concept of the contours and how to find out the contours from the topographical map. I will tell you. So contour means, contours are imaginary lines that joins the place of same height or elevation फ्रॉम द मीन सी लेवल. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? मतलब ये हुआ कि एक लाइन, एक इमेजिनरी लाइन है, जो लाइन क्या करता है सारे प्लेसेस को ज्वाइन करता है जिसका हाइट इक्वल है मीन सी लेवल से. सो इसी इमेजिनरी लाइन को हम लोग बोलते हैं कंटूर्स. और कंटूर्स एक वैल्यूएबल फीचर्स हैं टोपोसिट का. इसके थ्रू हम लोग किसी भी प्लेसेस का ऑल्टीट्यूड और हाइट निकाल सकते हैं. नॉट ओनली दैट, you can also find out a lot of physical features through the contour shape like cool, saddle, mountain, plateaus, waterfalls, gap, it means mountain gap, conical hill. These types of features we can easily identify through the contour. The contours is not only the features, it is an important features to represent the relief or the physical features in toposit. So now I will tell you the process to find out the contours from the toposit. So contours lines will be given in your topographical map through a brown line. So brown color line represent the contour lines, and one numbers will be given along with the lines. These are representing the height of the places from the mean sea level. So the brown numbers which are given along with the contour lines, these are very important. From those numbers, we can easily get the height of the place from the mean sea level. So next one is contour interval.
So we are going to discuss what is the concept of the contour interval.
Contour interval means the distance between consecutive contours. It means the gap between the two contour lines, that is called contour interval. इसका मतलब ये होता है कि दो कंटूर लाइन के बीच में जितना मीटर का गैप होते हैं इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं कंटूर इंटरवल. मान लेते हैं कि 400 का एक कंटूर लाइन है. सो उसके बाद जो लाइन ड्रॉ किया जाएगा वो कितना गैप में ड्रॉ किया गया, सो 20 मीटर के गैप में हो सकता है और कुछ भी हो सकता है, लेकिन मैप में हम लोगों के जो मैप आते हैं उस पर 20 मीटर का ही इंटरवल होते हैं. मान लेते हैं 400 का एक लाइन हम लोग ड्रॉ किए हैं, तो 400 मीटर का जो लाइन हम लोग ड्रॉ किए उसके बाद हम लोगों को ड्रॉ करना पड़ेगा 420 का. इस तरह से 20 मीटर गैप देके हम लोगों को कंटूर ड्रॉ करना पड़ता है. इसको बोलते हैं कंटूर इंटरवल. सो कंटूर इंटरवल्स मीन्स द गैप बिटवीन द टू कंटूर लाइंस, इट इज कॉल्ड कंटूर इंटरवल. नाउ आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ द वर्टिकल इंटरवल एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल एलिवेशन. वर्टिकल इंटरवल मीन्स द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू कंटूर्स इन वर्टिकल डायरेक्शंस, दैट इज कॉल्ड वर्टिकल इंटरवल. And next one is horizontal elevation. Horizontal elevation means the distance between the two contours in horizontal directions. That is called the horizontal elevation. After the discussion, I will show what is the actual meaning of the vertical interval and horizontal elevation with diagram. Okay, so come to the next point, that is spot height. It is another important features of toposit. So through these features, you can easily identify the maximum height of any places from the mean sea level. And before the discuss, I would like to say you the definition of the spot height. So spot definition is already coming in your screen. You can see it is the height of random places between contours. So कोई भी एक places का, random places का जो contours होते हैं उसके बीच में जो जो height होते हैं उसको हम लोग spot height बोलते हैं. So spot height को कैसे toposit में कैसे identify करेंगे. So now I will tell you the process to find out the spot height from your topographical map. So spot height always will be given by a black dot and one numbers also will be given along with the black dot, that is called spot height. So next one is triangulated height. So it is also a feature through which we can get the altitude of any places from mean sea level. So here one thing I want to tell you. How to find out the triangulated height from the topographical map. So one thing you have to remember, triangulated height always will be given by a triangle, black triangle, and one number also will be given along with the triangle, that is called triangulated height. So next one is that benchmark. It is another important features of toposit. So through the benchmark also we can get the altitude of any places from the mean sea level. And it is always will be marked on a stone pillar for the permanent reference. So one thing you have to remember, that how to find out the benchmark from the topographical map. So always it will be given by two capital number, one B, another M, and one numbers also will be given with those words, like these types of numbers will be given. I want to show you. Like that, 1B, capital B will be given, another capital M also will be given, and also one number will be given. Suppose it is 420. So this is this type of features you will get from your toposit. So these are called benchmark. Okay, so from the benchmark you will get the altitude of any places. And it is the permanent reference. So 420 is the height, and always it will be given in meter. So next point is gradient. Gradient is also known as the slope of land. We know that the surface is not plane, it is undulating. So there are so many slopes are present in the upper surface of the earth. So changing rate of the slope is called gradient. So as well as you can say the steepness of slope, it is known as gradient. So these are the different process to represent the relief in topographical map. So now I will show you one thing in the next slide. Here you can see a diagram on your screen, and you can see it is the 3D form of the features, and these features is made from the contour shape, and this is the process through which we can make the 3D form of the features from the contour shape. So go to the next. So now I will show you what is the actual meaning of the vertical interval and horizontal elevation. So here you can see that is through this diagram I will tell you what is the meaning of the vertical interval. Here you can see that is VI, it means vertical interval, that is 50 meter, and that is the vertical interval. You can see the gap between two contour or the distance between two contour vertical in vertical directions, that is called vertical interval. So what is the meaning of horizontal elevations? That is the horizontal elevation, you can say that is the horizontal elevation, it is the horizontal elevation. And so that will be the gradient, and always remember the gradient will be given by degree. So we need to move on to the next part. Now I will show you the different features from the topo set. So first of all, I want to show you the contour lines. So here you can see one numbers is given. Look at here very if you see this part very closely, so here you can see a number, that is 280, and one line is drawn. So that is this line is drawn by brown color, so this line is called contour lines, and that is the height of the place. So it is 280 meter from the main syllabus, so this is called contour line. And another contour line you will see over here, and it is 340, the value is 340, and so many lines are here. And if you see this part very closely, so you will see so many contours lines are here. So here you can see the density of the contours are very high, so it means the place is actually situated in any plateau region, or maybe it is the part of any plateau. So another things I want to show you, that is contour interval. So here you can see that is called linear scale, this graphical scale is called linear scale, and it is the contour interval of the map. Here you can see that is 20 meter, it is the contour interval, and 20 meter is given. Okay, so another thing I want to show, that is 1:50,000. You can see this is the RF scale, it is the representative fraction of the map. And next one, you can see a black dot with a black number along with the dot. So this dot, this black dot is called spot height, and the value of the spot height is 422 meter. It means the place height of the place is 422 meter from the mean sea level. One thing I want to show you, that is fire line. You can see it is given dotted line, black dotted line. What is the meaning of the fire line? Fire line means to protect the forest fire. Here you can see another features, that is five small R. So these are called, and not only fiber, here you can see 10R, 4R, here also 4R. So these are called relative height. This is the relative height of the embankment of this water bodies or dam, you can say. This is the relative height of the embankment also. This is the relative height of the river bank. Okay, so these are called relative height. Relative height always will be given by small r. Okay, and the height is 4 meter, it is also 4 meter, it is 10 meter, it is 5 meter. Okay, so these are called settlement, you know. This is metal road,
this is cut track, this is temple. Just look at here very closely, then you will see it is temple. This white area is called barren land or bad land, you can also say. It means the land which is not usable. Another features I want to show you, that is LY. It means the agricultural production is very low over here, that is low yield. So these are the different features of toposite. I'm showing you. I hope you will understand the different features from the topographical map. So go to the next part. Now I will show you the different picture of the physical features as well as the contour shape of all those physical features. So let's see. So that is the mountain. You know, it is the picture of the Himalaya, and in the right side here you will see this is the shape of the contour of a mountain. And in my next class I will tell you how to make the profile from contour shape. So these types of profile you can make through this shape. So I will explain the process how to make the profile from the contour shape in my next class. This is conical hill, you can see this is the example of the conical hill. It is actually situated in Sri Lanka. This is the shape of the conical hill, and if you make the profile from this shape you will get these types of features. Okay, there are so many process to identify the conical hill from the topographical map. Shape of the contours always will be circular, and the values of contour will be increased towards outside to inside. We will see the next features, that is plateau. You can see this is the picture of the plateau, and here one shape of contour is given, and if we are making the profile through this contour shape we will get this type of features. Next one is spur. This is the picture of the spur. You can see here one mountain is connected, another mountain is connected with this part. Through this shape we will get this type of features. Go to the next one, that is waterfalls. It is very important. You can see this is the picture of the waterfalls, and here one shape of contour is given, and you will see if we are making the profile from this contour shape we will get these types of features, and these are called nick point. 1, 2, 3, these are called nick point. Here the steep slope you will get. Okay, and now the next one is saddle. So this is the contour shape of the saddle, and if you are making the profile from this shape so you will get these types of features. So what is the meaning of saddle? Saddle means the gap between the two mountain peak, that is called saddle. So come to the next one, that is settlement pattern. So now I will tell you the different settlement pattern of toposite. So first of all I want to tell you what is the meaning of the nucleated settlement. So nucleated settlement means the settlements which will be built up very closely to each another. These are called the nucleated settlement. It means the gap between two settlements will be equal. Okay, so here you can see the gap between two settlements will be equal. Okay, so ये gap और ये gap दोनों equal है, और इधर भी देखिए आप लोग ये भी equal है, ये भी equal है. Gap between the two settlements will be equal, that will be nucleated settlement. It is also known as clustered settlement. Now I will tell you
what is the meaning of linear settlement? So linear settlement means when the settlements will be built up in besides of roadways, railways, any river. So these are called linear settlement, and it is also known as ribbon settlement. It will be just like a line. So come to the next one, that is called dispersed settlement. So what is the meaning of dispersed settlement? When the settlement will be built up very far from each another. So these are called the dispersed settlement. So here you can say the distance between two settlements will not be equal. Okay. So these are called dispersed settlement. Here you can see one diagram is given. I want to show you this distance and this distance is not equal. Okay. So the equal distance you will not found between each another. So that's why it is called dispersed settlement. Now I will show you the different type of settlement from the topographical map. So first of all, I want to show you the nucleated settlement or clustered settlement, and this is called nucleated settlement, and it is also a nucleated settlement. It is also a nucleated settlement. Linear settlement is not present on this map. Now I will show you the dispersed settlement. If you look this place very closely, so you will get the dispersed settlement. Why it is called dispersed? I want to show you this distance is not equal with this distance. So there is no equal distance. That's why it is called dispersed settlement. So these are the different features of toposet. So students, that's all for today. So viewers, I hope you enjoyed the class. So if you like this video, please share it and give your valuable suggestion in my comment box. I will meet with you again with a new video. Thank you so much for watching my video.